Well, Kai Rowles is surprised by his own healing powers as he pushes for a starting spot in the Socceroos World Cup opener against France. Rowles thought his dream had vanished with a serious injury, but now he's looking to make Australia's golden generation proud.
Under the Qatari sky, Kai Rowles continues his meteoric rise. That's remarkable, given it all came crashing down in August with a broken foot. He doubted he'd recover in time for the World Cup.
Yeah, pretty much. Like the whole time, but yeah, I mean, I had to come back super fast, and there's always a risk of pushing the limit a bit too much.
Playing a full match for Hearts 10 days ago, enough to blow away his own concerns.
Nah, it's gone from the back of my mind now, yeah. I'm 100% ready to go.
Graham Arnold's top 11 also features Harry Soutar, the Giants centre-back lacking match minutes as he returns from a knee reconstruction.
Yeah, he's looking fit and strong, and he's looking very sharp as well, so yeah, I can't wait to see him in action. Obviously, once you get into the game and you've got the likes of Benzema and Mbappe around you, you don't have time to kind of think about how you're feeling and stuff like that. You just got to do your job.
Gold does not rust, so no worries about these two members of Australia's best generation. Tim Cahill and Tony Vidmar enjoying a quick reunion with Mark Schwarzer, their presence not lost on the current crop.
You know, that 2005 journey was pretty much the most iconic football memory in my lifetime, to be honest with you, and that's really the moment that set off me wanting to get to this moment.
After this session, the Socceroos have four more before they take on France. It doesn't seem like a lot for the coaching staff, but feels an age for the players who can't wait to test themselves against the world champions. In Doha, Bence Hamerly for 10 News First.